and what to make of Lance, Cris. I mean, again, he doesn't have much tape, period, let alone recently. But everything I'm hearing, and he's going to be on tomorrow's show, I can't wait to interview him, is his inquisitiveness, his size, his quickness, his speed, everything together makes him the guy with maybe the biggest upside of everybody in the draft. And, you know, everything that you just said about what about a Shanahan offense that could have somebody creating a misdirection and then going a different way, and now you've got to actually cover him, not just because of his arm. It's fascinating to me. What's your evaluation of Trey Lance with you and PFF, Cris?
Absolutely huge arm. He reminds me a little bit throwing the ball of Colin Kaepernick. If you remember, Colin had a little bit of that three-quarter stuff, a little bit that, you know, that there were some accuracy issues, but he brought so much else to the table, you know. And Colin Kaepernick had one of the greatest quarterback games I've ever seen. We did a game in New England, and I went down for the pregame show with Bob Costas, and we were sitting in the tunnel. And I mean, Rich, it's just one of those days where it was like 30 degrees, the wind was like 40 miles an hour. We were all just freezing, sort of this misty, sleeting kind of rain, not quite snow. I went back up to the booth and I told Al, I go, I'm telling you, this game at best is 10-7. It ended up like 41-37 with Colin Kaepernick out-dueling Tom Brady coming down the stretch. One of the great quarterback games I've ever seen in my life. So I'm not putting down Colin Kaepernick, but if I had to put him in a category, I think Trey Lance is probably even a little more athletic version of Colin Kaepernick.
I thought you were going with the playoff game against Green Bay. I don't know if you called that game, but I thought that's what the
Kaepernick that game, but that was pretty good too.
Yeah,
is just one that stuck out of my mind because I was so convinced with the conditions that nobody was going to move the ball, and they just killed it.
Yeah, and I guess if you do take the concept that Garoppolo could be the guy, which is what Shanahan said in a press conference, at a very truthful press conference after the trade was done, that if, you know, Jimmy G's popular in the locker room, they can carry his freight cap-wise and let Trey Lance sit there. I mean, that because he definitely, from all the evaluators, needs some definite sit time and learning and to get up to speed. Man, that would be the answer.
Have you been keeping up with the crowd, the people in San Francisco want? I mean, it sounds like there's going to be a revolution if they end up taking Mac Jones. And there's nothing wrong with sticking to your guns. And
right.
I've known the Shanahans my whole life. Mike was my coach back in college at the University of Florida. So they stick to their guns pretty good. But the pressure is building to the point now where you start going, man, if they made that deal and they get Mac Jones and that didn't work out, and, you know, you start extrapolating that thing out. So I don't know. I still don't know what they're going
to
do.
Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.